now. Don't believe the haters. When it comes down to it, there is nothing quite like Altered Beast for a bit of gruesome, stylish weirdness in your platform game. Bearing in mind in context that this was kind of a first. This was kind of a first. I've gone from needing two punches to kill baddies to the one, to kill the smaller ones at least. Altered Beast, man, this was such a cool game. It's a very standard auto-scrolling platform game without any kind of without any kind of garnish really by today's standards, except for the ability to turn into this. Let's go. I used to love this game. Now the arcade version, again, one of those games where the arcade version has considerably more animation frames and considerably more garnish than the console versions and the computer versions. But, oh, it's so cool. By taking those frames out, they kind of turn into something a little more snappy. I loved Altered Beast. And I know a lot of people hated Altered Beast. I think what I loved about it, again, when I was a kid, and we're talking everything was pixel pop back then. 16-bit gaming was kind of the peak, you know, of pixel popping back then. This looked amazing. All the character designs, the monster designs. That dude was just throwing heads at me. His own head, which he was, regrowing inside him, which then popped back out, and he'd throw another one. Stuff like that. Man, that's so cool. I used to love all that. Random baddie designs. And this game was full of it. I loved also the fact that, okay, we've got the mechanic down now. We can punch, we can kick, and we can jump. And we know that those blue wolves contain orbs. And those orbs power us up. That's the mechanic. It's all pretty simple once you know what's going on with it. But every level gives you a different monster. And those... Those different monsters. Have different characteristics and different kind of attack. But don't get me wrong, they all have two attack patterns. Two attack methods. This guy has got... Oh, man, really? This guy has got that. And the only really useful weapon on this level. That... It's a blanker thing, a blanker ray. Of course, if you don't get those powers quickly enough, you've got to basically do the level again. Although with slightly different arrangements of baddies coming at you. I know it's simple, and I know loads of people diss it and don't think very much of it. In fact, I know if I did that, you get in the right place and do that. Yes, there you go. Insta-death for the baddie. A little trick of mine I'll share with you. But yeah, I remember this, it got a lot of hate. Not in the day. In the day it was considered really cool. But, you know, as a badly aging retro game, it got a lot of hate. And I don't think it deserves it. I think it was awesome. I particularly love the graphics. I'm skipping the cutscenes because I want to play it. But I particularly love the graphics. I love the big muscly dude. I think he's dead well drawn. I was trying to reproduce that in Deluxe Paint, that kind of style of animation. Really nice walk loop, considering it's only four frames. It's because his arms don't move too much, you know, he's just got that little bit of movement in the arms. And, I loved the simplicity of it, and the beauty of it, considering its simplicity. Oh, I'm going to lose that wolf. Oh, got it. This level's nasty for missing wolves. Oh, no. Oh, that nearly went wrong. Let's get that dude there. Got a tortoise dude. No. You can probably tell I've played this a bit before. Oh, no. Oh, I missed the wolf. I knew I missed that wolf. Oh, that teaches me to get smoked, doesn't it? Good damn wolf. See, now, this is what happens when you miss a wolf. The dude comes on. You can walk into that if you want, but it'll just take health off you. You don't really want to walk into that. And then you've got to kind of do another cycle of the level. All right, it's slightly different. I suppose they've designed a few cycles of the level. And now I've got to do the rest of that cycle as the bear. But that's cool, because the bear can kind of hold his own. Now, his two moves are turn stuff into stone, like that. And that's kind of useful, because then baddies coming at you. kind of bounce off the stone. We can't really see it happen there. It is affecting their path. Oh, there you go, there's another one. And this, that cool little move. Yeah, that's kind of good. Nearly killed myself doing it, like, but now if I turn into stone, for example, I ain't coming behind him now. We'll bounce off him, meaning I don't have to fight him. Well, that's not a lie. He's just proved me a lie. But hey, that's generally the idea. There we go. It's kind of a cool little trick. I wonder if he stays there when the baddie comes. Let's find out. What was the baddie? Oh yeah, that weird. Another weird dude. No, he disappears. Oh, this dude's weird. Okay, so if I remember right, I don't even know what it is. Lizard plant thing. Lizard slug. Hits him at the bottom, give him one of them. Loop. Hits him at the bottom, give him one of them. Or if you, I think you can give him a few of them if you're quick. Oh man. Oh. Should we carry on? Yeah, come on. Oh no, I hit start. Game over, man. Game over. Oh well, I'll let you discover the rest for yourself. Yeah, it's simple. Yeah, it's not particularly popular these days, but my god, it's good. Altered Beast, Sega Mega Drive. Thanks for watching.